bug, if there is any error or any bug in your system, your developers or your team will fix any bug or issue in the code or that. Then documentation. So you will write what are different kind of explanation you want to give to your customer, how to use that in instructions, means you will give some instructions in that. What kind of languages you have used there, what is the scope of your project. So you will give a detailed information in that documentation, or if your software wants to be modified in future or not. So in this way, you will create a documentation, and then you will control the version, such as Git, at Git, you will control the versions or re-versioning of your software. So that was all how you are going to implement your tags. So these are the 3 points that comes are that are very important. First of all, you will do the analysis whether you can perform that or not. Then you will design that, and after that you are going to implement it. So that is the software engineering practice, means how if you want to be a software engineer, then you have to practice these 3 things. Means you have to do the analysis, you have to create a design, and after that you have to implement them. So in this way you will then review your code. Now you are, after doing a lot of testing, debugging, you will review that my code is correct and now it is ready to deploy. Now you will deploy it, and then like you will just, if it is a website, then you will transfer your or deploy your website on from local server to the main server. Or if it is an Android application, then you are going to register that on Google Play or on Apple Store if it is an iOS application. So in this way, you will going to complete all the 3 phases in software engineering. Now let's move towards the next topic, that is explain multidisciplinary nature of software development. So here we see what is the nature of software development and how it will change time to time. Now we will see software development and business information, how software development is closely related with business, or how the business is totally depending on software applications, or how software development impacts the business. Now that we will see the customer software solutions are plays a very important role. So if you are running a business, so software developers can work with business stakeholders, means many business organization comes to software companies or software organization to build some softwares for their business or organization. So being a software developer, you get great chances to gather many business clients related to business world, so that you can address their need effectively, means you can create different multiple solutions for their business. So in this way, software development creates customer software solutions. Then enterprise planning systems, means it you can integrate various business processes like accounting, like you can create softwares for accounting. You can see that for accounts there, whenever you visit bank, each and every accountant there have their own software for you can say for gathering the deposits, for doing the transfer, whatever it is. So the account manager have their own accounts. No one can manually can do the large calculations. For doing larger calculations, you need a software. For human resource, now what comes in human resource, they will keep the details of their all employees, what each or every employee are going to do, their personal information, their details, when they join, when they leave, everything the human resource have to do. If they will do manually, it will take a lot of time and effort, so that's why they need individual software for that. In inventory management, that keeps the track of each and every items or products or material in any organization, there is another software, means how many items does you do purchase, when you brought them, when you are going to sell out them, what is the expiring date, selling dates, everything you have to keep track of that. For that, you can also build a software. So you can do all of these things into a single platform. Software developers can design, can implement, also can customize this ERP system. These all systems are called ERP systems that you can build. Then you can perform, or you can also improve efficiency. So by creating solutions for all of these ERPs, you can help them in their work and also save their time. Then data management and analytics. Here in data management and analytics, what you have done, business generates vast amount of data. Means each and every business have a large amount of data, data of their client, data of their user, their employees. Means they have to keep a track of their sales transaction, their customer data, everything they have to check out that. So software developers can create a data management system where they can manage their data, they can manipulate their data, they can collect, store, or analyze their data for their decision-making purpose. They can make decisions based upon that data. So software developers can create a data management system. So this is how the nature of the software development can change time to time. It can develop the software for ERPs, for enterprise resource planning systems. They can build data management systems. So they can do anything. They can also create or build customer relationship management system. Now, what is a customer relationship management system? How business manages or interact with their customers means they can track their sales, they can improve their customer satisfaction, they can satisfy their customers, how they're going to satisfy their customers, so they can create software for that. Then e-commerce platform that are most modern or that are very used in nowadays, like for selling their products and services online, you can build an e-commerce website application. That application can provide different features like product catalog is there. You can manage your shopping. You can add different secure payment processes for that purpose. You can include all of that. Then business intelligence tool, as I say that if someone wants to integrate artificial intelligence in their business, then software developers can also do that. Then mobile application plays a very important role. You can enable your employees to access data and perform tasks on the go. Like software developers can design mobile application for various purpose, like online attendance system by downloading. You create an app for attendees. Your employees can install their apps in their mobile phones and can update their attendees, or they can also get their salaries from that requested app, whatever it is. So you can increase productivity by creating different mobile application. Different people from different business comes to you for creating mobile application for their business. So in this way, this is all about the nature of software development, how it is going to change with the passage of time. How time to time the software can change their nature according to the customer or user requirement, softwares can easily change their nature. So moving towards our next topic, here we will see some organizational aspects of system development. How system development have impact on organization, or what are the different things that involves here? Like the system development projects can be successful if they meet the organizational objective and can deliver a value to your stakeholders. So here the software engineering theory says that if you meet your organizational objective, then you can be able to deliver a successful project. Now, how you can deliver a successful project to any organization or any business organization, or whether you have a business client, how you are going to deliver a successful project to them. So first of all, you will make a plan, means how you are going to align their need with IT, with overall business. You will meet their business needs, what are their business different needs and how you are going to meet that. Now it can be a clear objective, means you will define yourself. This is the clear objective. Like let's say that it is, let's say, if it is a bank application, if we take that exa same example that we used before, so what will be their objective? The client can easily deposit any amount, can easily withdraw money, can transfer money from one location to another, can request the loan, can get the loan. So this can be their objective. So you have to define their clear objective in order to create any software for them. Or if we talk about a hospital management system here, so what are the different features requested for any hospital management system? That system can be able to record the details or history of any patient. The system can be able to record the history of their employees. The employees can be a doctor or any staff of that hospital. The medical report of each and every patient should be recorded on that system. That can be the objective of that hospital management system. So in this way, while doing the planning, you have to clearly define their objective, their priorities, their requirement for system development in order to get the organizational goal. So you have to do that. You have to clearly define what that organization wants from that project. Then you have to do a project management. So project management and system development is very important. That can be include the scope of that project, means where that software is going to be used. Means if it, let's say if it is a software management system, it can only be used in hospitals. We cannot use that same system in educational institutes. So you have to define the objective, then the scope of that project. Then you have to allocate the resources, like what are the different resources you require in order to create that project? Means how many systems you are required, what is the server requirement there, what will be the hardware requirement of that system? You have to ensure that. Then you have to ensure the timeline, the budget that you have to in order to create that project. You want the specific budget for that. So all of these, you have to manage the project. And for that purpose, you can hire a project manager if you are not good at managing a project. Then you also have to, after that, you also have to engage your stakeholders. Like here, you have to ensure that their needs, you have to address their expectations. Now, again, repeating the same thing. Your stakeholders can be your users, your managers, your IT staff that you have to incorporate with them so that you can easily make decisions that how you are going to deal with and work with them. Now, again, you will repeat the same cycle. You will, after all doing that, you will do your requirement analysis. You will see your team collaboration. Means you have to create a discipline among your team. Means you have to communicate with your developers, your designers, your testers, each and every person. You have to motivate them for their work. You have to monitor them whether they're doing their work properly or not. So team collaboration is very important here. Then change management. Here, the change management also involves the change in the existing processes, the workflow. Means if you want to change something with the existing system, so are you are able to meet that change or do that change or not? Means let's say you have created a hospital management system and with us for a specific hospital, then you have to create a hospital management system for another software, but they want some additional functionalities in them. So what you will do, you will use that existing one, and instead of recreating that, you will add some more features to that existing one. So in this way, in this order, you are able to manage the changes that you want to do. So this is all that comes under the organizational aspects of system development, that how you are going to meet that. Then quality assurance is very important. Means you have to ensure the quality of your system. Means whether it is going to meet the user expectations or not, whether your project is achieving success or not. You have to assure their quality. For that, the quality assurance officer will be responsible for that. Means he will track the quality of your software. Then training and support. For example, your user does not know how to use that software. Now, how you are going to educate your user? Like you can provide a help option there. A help desk, you will provide an online virtual help desk will be integrated in that software. And if there is any new training, how you are going to train that person? So in this way, that is very important while creating a system development software. Then again, that documentation is very important. Let me show you a documentation here, how it looks like. I think I have shown you in the last lecture. So again, I will show you here so you might get some idea that if you are working on any project, then how you are going to work with that. So let me show you one here. This is how a documentation will look like. You will, for deadline, you will create a simple create a Gantt chart. You will give all these specific requirements for a project. Then you will give the information about the first deliverable, like feasibility report. Here it will include what will be the feasibility report of your software, like which languages you are going to use, or what are the desired languages are used, or what are the allocated requirements here, what will be the use case here. So these are all the requirement metrics is mentioned here. Then if I show you, these are the different diagrams that can show the working of your system software, means this is the domain model of any system. Then this is the system sequence diagram, how the system is going to work with. Then this one is the class diagram. So in this way, the documentation will create contains all the working of your software, how your software is going to work, what are the different deliverables, different testing criteria. See, this is the use case of the requested software. So in this way, you will create a documentation for, see, this is the architectural diagram of the system. So in this way, the documentation contains all about the working of your software, how it is going to work, what are different details in that. So you will include any of them. Then afterwards, now let's see what are different aspects of software engineering, means what is a programming team. Now in software engineering, a programming team is a group of people who collaborate with each other to develop software solutions. Like your programming team can consist of programmers, engineers who are going to work together to in order to create any software. Then how this programming team is going to work. First one is the role and responsibilities. Like who is going to do what? Like front-end developer will create the UI design, as I mentioned. The back-end developer will create the back-end. In this way, each person have their own roles and responsibilities, and according to their roles, they are going to perform their responsibilities. Then collaboration, they will collaborate with each other in order to share different ideas, their efforts to ensure that they are going to meet the project goal efficiently, effectively. Then task allocation means that project manager will allocate each and every tasks to each and every team member on the basis of their skills. Then they will be review their code, they will do the version controlling, and by using Agile, they will create the software in the iterative manner or in the form of modules. They are going to create that software. Then there will be integration. As I mentioned, they can integrate different APIs there. Then they can implement CI and CD pipelines, means for doing automations, means if they want to integrate any repetitive tasks, just like if there is any tasks that have to be done on daily basis, then how they are going to do that. For that purpose, for automation purpose, they will hire a person there. Then there are different roles for software engineering, means software developer is a person who will design or create or test the code. Then there is a quality assurance engineer who is responsible for testing the software. System analysis will analyze the business requirements or user needs, means whether they are going to develop or design their system or not. whether they are able to design their system or not. So then there can be a database administrator, means who is responsible for designing the database. So that was all about today's lecture. Okay, then if the lecture is clear, we are going to end our lecture here.